How's it going, everybody? Elephant Ninja here, and welcome back to another Terraria tutorial video. This time, it's gonna be a crafting guide on the one and only legendary informational item, the cell phone. Okay, it's not a nose. Oh yeah, the cell phone items. Yeah. So you basically need all of these to craft each individual part of the phone. And a magic or ice mirror at the end in order to finish making it. So yeah, the phone is basically comprised of four different parts. Well, I might have to set apart a bit of space to make some of these. But here are the first three parts. The gold watch, which you can craft with 10 gold bars as well as a chain. You can also do the same thing with the platinum watch. The platinum watch will also work for this. Then we have the compass, which drops from salamanders, crawdads, giant shellys, mother slimes, piranhas, snow flinxes, and armored Vikings underground. Yeah, that's crazy. And undead Vikings. Yeah, all of those can drop a compass. And depending on the version you play, on PlayStation 3 and, of course, 3DS and Xbox 360 versions of Terraria, the compass will also have a random chance to drop from the, the mimics. Then we have the depth meter, which drops from every single bat in the game. Well, most of the bats that you encounter. Yeah, it drops from salamanders, giant shellys, and crawdads. But it can also drop from the, the cave bat, the jungle bat, the ice bats, and the giant bats. That's absolutely insane. Yeah, it's also craftable in the other version with, I think multiple different bars to make the depth meter. Yeah, so the GPS is the only item from the phone that can literally be craftable in every single version of Terraria. As the rest of these are basically highly reliant on other versions. So yeah, we're about to craft the legendary GPS from the gold watch, depth meter, and compass, and it should look something like this. Yeah, I got myself a rash GPS. And yeah, I went steps further this time. Not only am I basically providing information about this and making a bunch of cell phones for my friends Mirza, Vibes, and Shinobi, but currently, I'm also making the one for Sydney as well. My youngest sister who has that, that house in the sky that I made for her. As an homage to the old Xbox 360 series we would usually play together. But, here's the next one. So next we have the pieces to make the REK-3000. So you need a radar, a tally counter, and the lifeform analyzer. Now, the radar has a chance of spawning from basically appearing in surface chests randomly as different loot. The tally counter can be obtained whenever you kill dungeon enemies by chance. And the lifeform analyzer can just simply be bought by the traveling merchant for 5 gold coins. So yeah, not too much of a stretch with the lifeform analyzer. Yeah, I should basically say the effects of all of these different ones. So basically, for the GPS, basically shows, the depths you are at in the world, I think how east or west you are with the compass, and of course, tells the time because of the watch and stuff. But yeah, once you combine the radar, the life form analyzer, and the tally counter together, you will be able to... Yeah, you'll be able to find rare creatures, display how many monsters have been killed, and detect enemies around you. So yeah, this is absolutely amazing, honestly. And if you're basically depending on making a lot of banners for these different enemies, the tally counter most definitely is a must. Because yeah, if you don't have the tally counter, then it's going to be hard to keep track of all those enemies because it'll seem very random. But yeah, using the tally counter, life form analyzer, and radar, boom! We have the REK 3000. Wow, and Sydney's REK 3000 has been forged to fleeting. 2%, extra 2% movement speed, wow. Okay, I won't say that's the worst effect, but it seems kind of mediocre in my opinion. Alright, next up is the Goblin Tech. And you need these different items to... yeah, all three of these items to make it. So the DPS meter and the stopwatch... Hold on, that's not right. I did not mean to do that. Hold on, I will get this all back together. Hold on. There we go. Alright, putting it in my inventory like so. Okay, as I was saying! Yeah, the DPS meter and the stopwatch can both be bought from the traveling merchant, just like with the lifeform analyzer. And the metal detector drops from the nymph enemy. 50% chance on normal, and yeah, 100% chance on expert and master modes. So yeah, in those very high difficulty worlds, the nymph will drop the metal detector every single time. That is absolutely nuts for an enemy to rarely drop items and be a 100% drop. That is absolutely insane. I mean, wow, I guess it could basically be compared to the Guardian from the dungeon if you don't defeat Skeletron, as he always drops the Bone Key upon death, but I digress because he's tough, the Nymph obviously isn't. But yeah, here we go. DPS, stopwatch, and metal detector combined together to make the Goblin Tech. And Sydney's has been... Sydney's has been forged to precise Goblin Tech. Okay, I think I'll sell these extra lands. There you go, buddy. Just making some more room in the inventory for the last item that you basically need to craft the PDA for the cell phone. So yeah, the last items we got here are the Fisherman's Pocket Guide, the Weather Radio, and the Sextant. Now, all three of these items can very randomly be obtained whenever you complete fishing quests. So yeah, and because it's always random, yeah, don't rely on it too much. Just don't do it, fam. Yeah, it's not like luck is going to go your way all the time. So yeah, I did have to do like so many fishing tasks just to get these all those four fisherman's pocket guides. Actually, come to think of it, I'll check in the accomplishments like how many of these fishing tasks I've done. Okay, I'm scrolling all the way down here. How many of these have I done? Pretty sure I've done like a lot because I've been grinding them. Yeah, 151. It took 151 quests for me to finally get that last and final, I'm pretty sure you obviously know, that final Fisherman's Pocket Guide. But yeah, we got, wow, I am definitely ready to craft Sydney's cell phone. Let's get her PDA ready with the GPS. The REK 3000, the Goblin Tech, and the Fishfinders. We have the BDA. Alright, armored BDA. And the final crafting, which we can do with either a magic mirror or an ice mirror. Boom, we got the cell phone. Now, yeah, the cell phone, it displays a whole lot of information. Yeah, I think I'll actually move my camera probably to the bottom left so that you can see all of it. But yeah, there's time, there's rain, there's time, there's weather, there's moon phase, there's fishing, there's treasure, there's rare enemies, there's enemy counter, enemy kills, DPS, your speed, as well as, the depth that you're at, and the direction of the world, be it east or west. So yeah. So yeah, that is pretty insane, honestly. Yeah, making the cell phone. So this is the one for Sydney. Alright, I'm so glad I was able to make that for you guys. Oh man, on camera and everything. Alright, so I'm not just gonna make one cell phone and just leave it for this entire video. I'm about to make these other three. So yeah, be ready. Yeah, get ready and patient, people. So yeah, the GPS, REK, and Goblin Techs of Mirza and his friends, I've already had completely crafted. So I don't have to craft them. Yeah, for the other parts though, yeah, I might have to craft it. But, yeah. Okay, yeah, this ain't too bad. Okay, got all the Mirza stuff. The first in every column. Alright. Mirza has his fish finder, his BDA. Oh, I gotta find a mirror. An ice mirror. Or magic mirror. I think it's in there. Hold on. Ah, there it is. There it is. Magic mirror. Magic mirror.
Do you have red scissors?
No, I don't, Cindy. I don't have any red scissors. Oh boy. Yeah, sorry about that. Cindy did kind of come in asking for scissors and stuff. But yeah, here we go. Crafting Mirza's cell phone. Yes. Mirza has a cell phone. I hope you guys are happy for that. Oh, yes. Yeah, the legend himself. And I'm about to fix the same exact thing up for the rest of his friends, so... Yeah, definitely doing this, very quick yet painstaking process. Alright, crafting them with the fish finder, then getting the magic mirror. Okay, so now we're doing Shinobi. There's his magic mirror. We're gonna need this to make the cell phone. Bam! There we go. Alright, and finally we have, and finally, we have Sad Vibes. Yeah, let's go ahead and do this. So, all of his phone stuff. Yeah, there's the last of it. There's the last of the cell phone items. Oh, I forgot to put, okay, there we go. There we go, got the cell phone successfully put away. I'll actually trash the gold ore real quick. Okay, fish finder, PDA, and cell phone. There we go. Yeah, that is amazing. There's literally 13 things that the cell phone can do. And yeah, it is a very amazing informational item. Giving you like 12 things right there on the right corner. As you can basically see just below the map right there. All 12 of those effects. Oh boy. I'm sure a couple of videos you've probably seen some of those same effects over my camera that would usually be there. Oh boy, that is absolutely insane, dude. Man, you're probably absolute legends if you did that. Oh boy. But yeah, there's so many things that the cell phone can do. So basically, it tells you time, it tells you the weather, it tells you the moon phase, your fishing power, your treasure, nearby treasure, rare enemies. Let's see, a number of enemies that are there, the kill count, the DPS, how far east and how far east or west, and also how far in depth you basically become. And also the cell phone can teleport you home, like so. So yeah, that's another thing I really like about the cell phone in this game. Oh wow. Crafting the cell phone. Yeah, definitely does seem to be a much shorter video than expected compared to the Hunk Shield. That's because for some of this, despite how many items and how many fishing quests I had to do for this, there basically wasn't really that much explaining for me to do, so. Yeah, I hope you're also very happy for me giving Mirza and his two friends their amazing cell phones, as well as my sister Sydney a cell phone. Man, I am very happy that I was able to make it for them. Of course, they still don't have their items right now, and yeah, I basically was making these gifts since December, so. Yeah, apparently I still don't have PlayStation Plus, like, on my PlayStation 4 yet. Yeah, hopefully if Mirza and his friends do want to come online and I do have PlayStation Plus, I can basically get them started on an adventure in Terraria and give them all the amazing items that they're most definitely going to need. Yeah, definitely not gonna give them OP items like the Meowmer sword or the Space Dolphin machine gun. The game wouldn't even be fun at that point, would it? Oh man. Yeah, that's why I'm basically giving them simple armor and simple objects and everything like that. That are just like in the middle of hard mode and not like post-moon mode. Like with the Meowmer and the Space Dolphin machine gun, as I just mentioned. Oh boy. Man, the cell phone. Very glad I was able to craft this. I have been waiting literally months and months just to make this video. Yeah, that's crazy. And it's crazy that I had to do over 150 fishing quests just to finally get exactly what I needed to make this video. Wow, that shows how absolutely insane Terraria can be sometimes with the fishing though. Oh boy. Yeah, I really hope you guys did enjoy, like, learning how to craft the cell phone yourself. Which you can also basically do in pre-hard mode, unlike with the Onk Shield. Yeah, with the Onk Shield, you kind of have to do most of it in hard mode. Yeah, you can get a few of the items in pre-hard mode for the Onk Shield, but yeah, the rest of it's basically hard mode. Man, just thought I'd give you an amazing guide that wasn't so hard to do for a majority of you people. And yeah, the cell phone definitely does not sound very difficult, so I thought, heck, why not give it a shot? Man, Mirza, I really hope you and your crew did enjoy this video as well. Oh boy. Man, as I'm slaying some bunnies as well, so sorry for that. People who really love bunnies. Ugh. Rest in peace, little bunnies. I'm so sorry for that. But yeah, I've basically been rambling for long enough and everything. I'm kind of stretching the ending. I'm very, very sorry for that. Oh boy. Just thought there was one more thing I decided to mention before ending this video. So, the Classic Ninja Pack came back, right? And I was able to get, Classic Noob Cybot in, Mortal Kombat Mobile. Then the Dawn of Justice Pack came in Injustice 2 Mobile, featuring, Justice League Superman and, Nightmare Batman. But guess what I got, obviously. On the first try, and with just enough gems to do it, a basically 3-star unlock for Collector of World Superman. So, yeah. Man, I'm pretty happy for that insane luck. Oh boy. Also, if some people actually do have extra Justice League Superman shards, yeah, feel free to give them to me because, yeah, I kind of have a 4-star Justice League Superman. Yeah, and I did also recently unlock Martian Manhunter, so I got a 3-star Martian Manhunter as well. Oh boy. Man, that is absolutely crazy. Really thought you guys basically did enjoy this whole video, like, crafting the phone and everything. Yeah. Elephant Slice, that like button, subscribe today to join the Elephant Ninja Clan, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody.